Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. In this video, we are going to see how the movie Moana is being analyzed through the eco-criticism approach. This video would go on by this flow: introduction of eco-criticism, nature as accepting, reconciliation with nature to restore balance, eco-feminism, and conclusion. Eco-criticism is the study of the relationship between literature and the physical environment. Eco-criticism can be applied through these three approaches, which are: first one, questioning the representation of nature by looking at the role of nature in a text and how it is represented; second, looking at nature writing; and the third one, examining eco-critical issues and questions. For our analysis of Moana, we apply the first approach, which is by questioning the representation of nature.
Let's look at the place and setting of Moana. The entire movie revolves around nature and presented by people that appreciates nature. First, we have the island where Moana and her tribe resides, island of Motunui. The next one is the most obvious setting, which is the ocean. Ever since Moana was little, she was always drawn to it, though there were several instances she was restricted by chieftain father Tui. After her grandma Tala passed on, she figured it was her responsibility to travel beyond the island's reef and save the island. Next, Maui's island. Maui was exiled alone without his magical fishhook as he was punished by lava demon Takar for his crimes. Moving on to Lalutai, or also known as Realm of the Monsters, it is situated on a remote island and the entrance to Lalutai can be accessed atop a high mountain. The passageway, which is a pit, leads to an undersea environment home to a number of exotic, fearsome, and ferocious creatures, one of which being Tamatoa, a villainous giant crab. And finally, the island of Tafiti. It embodies the island goddess Tafiti. She fell into a deep slumber and became an island after giving and creating all life.
What can we observe from Moana's film as a whole is that it emphasizes on a reconciliation between nature and human being in order to restore balance within the human-nature relationship. Reconciliation with nature is one of the main plotline of this film. The reconciliation is represented through Moana's act of returning the heart of Tafiti to its original position for the benefit of her tribe. Moana started her journey by embarking on a voyage which was forbidden by her father. Along the way, she teamed up with Maui and overcame many challenges, such as trapped by the giant crab, hit by big waves, and having to learn new constellations. Finally, with the help of Maui, she was able to retain the heart of Tafiti and save her tribe. Moana's act of returning Tafiti's heart tells the importance of returning back what mankind has taken from Mother Nature, thus reconciling with the nature itself. By doing so, mankind is not only able to benefit from nature, but it also ensures the continuity of our mankind. Moana's hardship along the journey signifies that it is not easy for human beings to recognize a mistake and take even the first step to correct them. Just like the hardships faced by Moana, people who advocate and try to reconcile with nature in real life also face many hardships, such as resistance from people who actually profit from exploiting nature. However, like Moana, one must persist in reconciling with nature and thus restore the balance in the relationship between human and nature, so that we will benefit in the long run.
Moving on to the eco-feminism. What is eco-feminism? So basically, eco-feminism examines the connection between women and nature. The element of eco-feminism could be seen in this movie through the depiction of the main character, which is Moana. According to the eco-feminists, they believe that women are inherently closer to nature, biologically, spiritually, and emotionally. This has shown where Moana, the main character, and also a woman was able to put back the heart of the Tafiti, which is the goddess of nature. She was also managed to solve the problems concerning the disaster caused by nature. Although there are other men in this movie that could be chosen as the one responsible to put back the heart of Tafiti, Moana was still the chosen one. Even the goddess of nature in this movie also is depicted by a figure of woman. So as a whole, we could see that this movie portrays the deep relationship between women and nature through the characters of Moana and Tafiti, which implies the element of ecofeminism.
Before I go into a conclusion, I would like to share with you one of the quotes from William Wordsworth. To every nature form, a rock, flower, or fruits, even the loose stone that cover the highway, I give moral life. From this quote, we learn that nature not only provide us with great experience, but nature also complement our life. Therefore, Moana tries to tell the world that restoring nature is one of the important elements in our life, because when you liberate nature, you liberate yourself.